G'day, Glenn Morris from the Smart Energy Lab. And today, the good people from Solplanet have sent me their latest Grid Connect inverter. It's the 8 kilowatt unit with the 3 MPPTs, but they actually come in a range of sizes. So let's check it out. So this unit here is, like I said, the 8 kilowatt, but you know, it'll suit a range of different customer requirements, 6, 8, and 10. Now, the fact that it's got 3 MPPTs, now that is just awesome. Means you can do some really interesting arrangements of panels on the terrible roofs that people often build these days with all those facets and hips. That's a big plus. It's got a really high input current on those MPPTs, 16 amps. Now that's great for the high current modules that we're dealing with these days. So big plus there. It's got an integrated DC isolator that's approved. So no problems with having to install an external DC isolator. Bit of a pain that one is. It's IP66 of course, so it's gonna go outside. It's pretty lightweight. I mean, I just picked it up. It's a bit less than 18 kilograms. So a nice single person lift. And it uses the tallest Phoenix DC connectors. So none of those tricky MC4s, you just push it in. So strip the wire and push it in. Pretty much tallest apart from stripping the wire, of course. And it's got a wide MPPT voltage window, starting down at as low as 80 volts. So that's a big plus. And wait till you see the color. It's beautiful. Let's get into it. Well, it's in here. Let's check it out. Safety first. Gonna be using my favorite sharp knife. I don't know why boxers sometimes say don't use knives. What are you supposed to open them with? A pair of fingernails? Okay, safety. Here we go. Now, first impressions, opening the box, wow, is a lot of lovely cardboard. Now, this kind of gets me a bit juiced up. I hate having to get rid of lots of non-recyclable packaging. So yeah, this is engineered cardboard. I mean, it's amazing stuff really, the way it's organized to create volume and strength and just kind of be a recyclable commodity. So let's pull out these components. Mounting plate, nice and simple, straightforward. It's even got a little arrow showing which way up. Like this, so that's kind of cool. So the all-important energy meter for measuring the amount of cell consumption versus generation. So the inverter itself measures its own generation, but this meter also allows it to see the amount of consumption and for export limiting. That's a big plus. So provide export limiting capability. Now these are the, I call this the lolly bag. So, kind of fun name for it. We've got a bunch of stuff in here. We've got our AC connectors. We've got our Phoenix No Tool DC plugs and sockets for connecting the DC cables to the unit. So that's pretty nice. We've got our ubiquitous Wi-Fi dongle that will be used to connect this thing to the cloud. And we've got some documentation here on how to mount it, including clearances, etc. So, oops, wrong way around. Here we go. Now let me get this lovely engineered cardboard. Isn't this just amazing stuff, how it's built? I mean, instead of having loads of polystyrene, we've got this engineered bulk cardboard. Okay, I think this is about all of the non-recyclable component. This little bit of soft packaging foam. I suppose you could say the plastic bags, but really very little at all. Now we come to the main event. Here it is. So this is the 8 kilowatt unit. Remember, it comes in 6, 8, and 10 kilowatt varieties. And as you can see, there's our connectors along the bottom here. So first impressions on this unit, the color. I just love it. This kind of delicate blue, sort of gray blue, not offensive, not just another beige box, but anyway, color's a personal choice or passion. No on-screen display, because you've got a Wi-Fi dongle, you've got an app, and frankly, as much as I as an installer love an on-screen display when I'm commissioning a system, after that, really the customer probably only looks at it a half a dozen times before they just forget about it. They're more interested in its reliability and performance over time. And that's where an app comes. I mean, an app's gonna give you that sort of detail. It's gonna tell you what your self-use is, how much you're exporting to grid, importing from grid. So the analytics that an app can give you is way more than what you might just get on with an on-screen display. So looking at the bottom of this unit here, we've got our 3 MPPTs. Now, remember, 3. That's pretty cool in a, you know, the smallest unit being a 6, up to a 10 kilowatt unit, all having 3 MPPTs. We've got our usual plug and socket connections for comms, Wi-Fi dongle, AC in, and there's our integrated DC isolator that is compliant and approved. Great, great to have that. So this is kind of all you need. I mean, if you're installing it within a couple of meters of a switchboard, you don't even need an AC isolator adjacent to it. That's about it. Now let's have a look at the back. So you can see, well, it's really the top, the heatsink on this unit. Carefully done. Passively cooled, so no fans on the outside. So therefore, it's IP66. Doesn't require any internal cooling, so a lot of heatsink, and it's probably the chokes down here. It's worth noting that the manufacturer will tell you what the clearances are for installing from other material, other surfaces like adjacent equipment or a ceiling, and it's actually pretty important, because if you look at this heatsink, it's going to vent up and down vertically. It's going to need to have some space above it for convection to work well, and some space below it, and equally either side for some of that dissipation from the size of the unit. So just make sure you comply with the manufacturer's requirements in terms of clearances around an inverter. But there you go. That's the Solplanet 8 kilowatt grid connect inverter. Looking forward to getting it on the wall and making some good clean energy. Thanks, Solplanet. See ya.